Hello, my name is the Jordan Coach at the Virginia Lake Bolts, and I'm back for VBLS Season 9 Draft League Playoffs. Get hyped. For those outside the league, I wasn't making content for the past few weeks, but I finished the season at 6-1. I'm really thankful for this. I feel like I was playing among my best, and luck was on my side more often than not. So that's how you end up with first seed. But I was rewarded as first seed with Ray, the grand champion of last season, as my first round playoff match, and one of the most slanted matchups I have ever seen in my 2+ years of playing Draft League. I don't want to make this about complaining, though I do want to explain why the matchup is so challenging for me and make this as a story. If I win especially, but even if I don't, this is about grit, determination, keeping working. Even when things seemed hopeless, I got walloped repeatedly in mocks, but I kept talking it out. I put together some of my best effort I think I've ever put together team building for a match, and so ready to show you off my strategy for the week. But why is the match so challenging in a nutshell? My team loves to hit fast, hit hard, and refuse to play defense. If it has to play defense, it's pretty good at dealing with special attackers, but physical attackers are its main weakness. There's no intimidate here, there's no will-o-wisp except Ghastly, and generally poor physical defensive numbers. So enter some of the most aggressive, physically offensive team I've ever seen. Really great team. I ranked it number one in the power rankings overall. Ray is the Chimpao Dragonite, so he hits at the speed of priority. I'm faster than most teams, but nothing outspeeds priority. So the double up of these two destroys my whole team. Like, you'll see my super bulky defensive investments, but there are some things I simply can't live. I need to take some calculated risks, especially when you pile on the Iron Treads, the Serilege. They have so much power here. And so step one of trying to approach this match is to not die to priority moves, because if you're going to be KO'd by a priority move, no speed control will save you. So Dragonite's extreme speed is pretty good, but like Florges is pretty good at taking it, especially with nearly full physical bulk. But the problem is all the multipliers they can potentially stack on. Choice Band, they've been trying all season. Terra Normal and Sword of Ruin. If the Chimpao is out, all Mons have reduced physical defense, so it really exacerbates the problem on my team. And so that triples the power of a normal move, and Chimpao's hitting right next to it. There are some things I cannot live, no matter how great my physical defense investments are. But I'm going to have to choose my spots, and protects are key. You're going to see protect on a lot of Mons, because that's how I bait some moves and squeeze out a little bit of damage when they're not focused on one of my Mons. So protect reads are necessary, but we got to start with how I'm going to cobble together the damage. Iron Jugulus is the main damage dealer of the team this week. It's generally been setting Tailwind, clicking Snarl, being a more bulky kind of Mon for me, but I like it as a booster energy special attack because Dark Pulse hits most of their team very hard, Oko's on some key things, 2-8 KOs on most other things, and then Flamethrower as a coverage move hits some of their most important Mons very hard. I'm living the banded Terra Normal Dragonite Extreme Speed, and then if they have the additional multiplier and double ups that I can't live, Terra Steel is the best defensive Terra for living. Chimpao Ice Moves, Dragonite Extreme Speeds, and more. So I should be able to get two strong hits or one strong hit and a Tailwind at least. And so Jugulus, I'm probably going to protect it in the back, start with trying to soften things up so that Jugulus is ready to do a lot of damage. Florges is one of my tools to slow the game down. Sometimes I will get trampled, and some of these games potentially are going to look like I didn't get to do anything. But if I can get the Chilling Water, cut their offense, if I can get the Charm, cut their offense even more, and then get a berry, then I can actually live a few more turns than you might expect with the full bulk. And Florges is naturally really specially bulky, so their main special offensive threat, I live 2 Terra Electric Rotom Thunderbolt. So I can turn into a water, which would make me better. As the surprise defensive Terra helps me live the Serilege, helps me live the Iron Tread Steel move, so I can slow the game down, cut their offense, deal good damage at the same time. So Floor just helps me slow the game down, but how do I get the offense? I gotta accelerate my offense if I'm running nearly full bulk rather than offensive investment. Eel really helps with that. So Eel, more bulk, allows it to live 1 or 2 hits and land a key acid spray so that their defense is halved and my next move move. Double power with Florges, double power with Ion Jugulus can take a lot of Okos. So at the very least, if it forces him to switch, that's another way I can gain momentum. I need to be very picky. One stab move plus one coverage move hits basically everything for one shots or two shots. And then the protect. Protect reads are necessary. You see all three of these mons have protect. But I also have another source of mayhem and disruption in the Klefki. No Will-O-Wisp. Sometimes you have to make your own Will-O-Wisp. So you trick a Flame Orb, you steal their item, and you burn them. Pretty nice. And so people don't normally expect Klefki to be as aggressive and disruptive from turn one. It might usually just be setting a Reflect, but this time I could steal Dragonite's Choice Band, and I'm even ready if I get a random Choice Band to click Foul Play, use their very strong physical attack stats against them. Facade, if I don't get to trade my item and I burn myself, then Facade gains double damage. So they should have trouble getting through the Klefki. It's naturally the best type for dealing with some of these attackers as a steel type. So I slow some things down, and then I put Jugulus and Florges and Eel in better positions to land more hits. So an additional piece of this is Hax. Hax is important because Hax, one time, a 30% flinch chance feels random. But if you can land three or four, then you're likely to get at least one. Then it becomes expected. So if I get Jugulus going first, the Tailwind, 20% flinch odds off Dark Pulse are not nothing. They definitely can really help me, and they're part of my outs. When you feel like you're behind, you have to be risk-seeking. I don't want to have risks untaken. So, Garchomp is mostly here as a one-game gimmick. Scarf, Rock Slides, get some flinches. It breaks Dragonite Multiscale at the same time. It breaks Chien Pao Sash. So it has a fair amount of uses, but mainly it's just here to get spread damage and to fish for some flinches. It actually really can help. And so Rock Tomb as a speed control move is pretty good. The stabs are good, but this is mainly here to soften things up so that my sweepers can have a slightly easier job once Garchomp goes down. The bulk allows it to live a Chien Pao Ice Shard, an Adamant Ice Shard, and if they have double ups, then Rock is decent, at least for trading out my weaknesses, still resisting extreme speed, and then boosted Rock Slides, why not? So lastly, this is another disruptive piece, but all these mons need to be able to do a little bit of damage. So Fake Out really helps me win one turn. Close Combat is very good against Treads, against Chien Pao, and then Foul Play, another time using their offensive stats against them. I never run Protect on Toxicroak yet, but maybe it's unexpected. I bet it's unexpected. And so getting those one turns where their biggest threat trades with your Protect, that's the only way I'm going to be able to overcome some of the offensive pressure. Ray's put together an incredible team, but I think I've put together an incredible build. So we'll see which one wins. I'm not doing a live commentary for this one. Like other playoff matches, mine will be streamed. So it might be streamed on my channel or someone else's, and maybe I'll be commenting. I'm not sure yet, but the info about seeing this match will be in the description. Even if I lose, I feel proud of what I put together, and even if I lose, you'll still see content, playoffs content, on this channel. So stay tuned for that. Have a nice day, everyone.